After the fight with Muhammad Ali, I was devastated. I lost with my beloved heavyweight championship of the world. I wanted revenge. But time was softened for me. He called me somewhere in the late 70s and said, George, would you do me a favor after complimenting me for about 20 minutes, 10 to 20 minutes? I said, what is it? He said, please come back and beat Ken Norton for me. He said, I can't beat him.
Regulators, mount up.
It was a clear black night, a clear white moon. Warren G was on the streets trying to consume some skirts for the E so I could get some phones. Rolling in my ride, chilling all alone.
Just hit the east side of the LBC on a mission trying to find Mr. Warren G. Seen a car full of girls, ain't no need to tweak. All of you search, know what's up with 213.
So I hooked a left on 21 and Lewis. Some brothers shooting dice, so I said, let's do this. I jumped out the rock and said, what's up? Some brothers pulled some gas, so I said, I'm pissed.
Since these girls peeping me, I'm gonna glide and swerve. These hookers looking so hard, they straight hit the curve. Want to bigger, better things than some horny tricks. I see my homie and some suckers all in his mix.
I'm getting jacked, I'm breaking myself. I can't believe they taking more than 12. They took my rings, they took my Rolex. I looked at the brother, said, damn, what's next?
They got my homie hemmed up and they all around. Can't none of them see him if they going straight pound for pound. They wanna come up real quick before they start to clown. I best pull out my strap and lay them busters down.
They got guns to my head, I think I'm going down. I can't believe it's happening in my own town.
If I had wings, I would fly, let me contemplate. I glance in the cut and I see my homie Nate.
16 in the clip and one in the hole. Nate Dogg is about to make some bodies turn cold. Now they dropping and yelling, it's a tad bit late. Nate Dogg and Warren G had to regulate. Switching my mind back into freak mode. If you won't skirt, sit back and observe. I just left a gang of those over there on the curb.
Now they got the freaks, and that's a known fact. Before I got jacked, I was on the same track. Back up, cause it's on N-A-T-E and me, the woman to the G.
Just like I thought, they were in the same spot, in need of some desperate help. But they dog and the G child were in need of something else. One of them names was sexy as hell. I said, ooh, I like your size. She said, my chords broke down and just sing real nice. Would you let me ride? I got a car full of girls and it's going real swell. The next stop is the East Side Motel.
To a whole new era. G-Funk, step to this, I dare ya. Funk, on a whole new level.
The rhythm is the bass, and the bass is the treble chord.
Ali was fighting Bob Foster in Lake Tahoe. I was on the undercard. We went to the bar area afterwards. There was a little episode where I was taking the women away from Ali. And he said, I'm gonna get you for that. I'm gonna get you, sucker.
Ali, who it seems to me has taken Kenny Norton more lightly in the pre-fight build-up here than any opponent I have known him to fight.
Howard Cosell said that this was going to be one of the greatest mismatches of all time.
Nope, he never did well against punches. But guys like Muhammad Ali and Larry Holmes, the boxers, gave them both warned.
I got in the best shape of my life ever for that fight. I matched Ali and everything. I would watch his chest. Every time he started the jab, it would flex. He knew it was coming. I would catch it with the right hand, then as soon as the jab touched the glove, he'd fire back, uppercut or jab. Each one that I tried worked. Not all the time, but 80% of the time.
Either Kenny Norton is a much better fighter than anybody thought.
The first Ali fight gave me a chance to give my son more food, better clothes. A fight with Ali gave me a chance at life, period.
The final round, round 12.
With Angelo Dundee saying, I broke his jaw in the second round, they're telling a story that will make their fighter look invincible. That Ali could take unsurmountable pain. I broke his jaw in the last round.
He knew his jaw was hurting, but he didn't know it was broken, so he's gonna keep it on going. And that's the man that come out of it.
Norton could beat him on any given night. I don't think he've ever beaten Kenny Norton, to be honest with you.
Frank Rustich, 7 points Norton, 5 points Ali. There it is. One of the greatest upsets in boxing history.
In 1986, after I retired, I was on the way home, going up onto the freeway, and my car somehow went over the ramp on about a 40-foot drop. And that's all I remember for 5 years. I cracked my skull. I couldn't talk, couldn't walk, couldn't go to the bathroom. I was paralyzed for 3 years. But when I was in the hospital, with my car wreck, Ali came to see me. And they said that I responded to be in the same ring with this man called Muhammad. It was just, to me, an honor, a lifesaver, career saver. And I can't thank him enough for giving me the chance.